What's up?
We'll be right back.
she'll dance, then he'll turn to a shadow. Says I'm wrong, like Sodom Claw. The autumn leaves turn over across your throat.
Some people raise their hand. I don't have hair anymore. I've been wanting to send Ben out first, and then be like, oh, it's the Hotelier guy. But we didn't do it today. Maybe tomorrow night. This next song is the song that makes us seem the most like a prom band. So if you wanna, you can feel free to use that disco ball liberally. Oh yeah! Welcome to prom, everybody. You're awakened. bring Chad. I run a label with Chad. And Chad's like a brilliant musician who I'm like often inspired by. We're playing with Foxing. Foxing has been some of our best friends in music for a very long time. And, you know, we're just taking it easy, you know? We used to do this a lot. And it was sometimes very fun and sometimes very tiring. We're taking it easy. And we're taking it easy tonight. And it's gonna be fun. We're not taking it easy tonight. We're gonna rock. This song rocks. It's called Rock. Dendron.
Thank you.
a lot of people in here. I'm gonna count while we wait for Chris to get the studio. I'm gonna count every single one of you. One, two. There's at least two. I think there's actually even more than 100 people in here. All right, I'll take one question. What do you got? Anyone? Question? How high can I count? Without giving up, probably, for no money, $310. $310. No dollar. I said one question. It's going fine. I'm not broke!
Yeah. whoever was in the jean jacket, are you okay? Because you smashed your head into my headstock. You good?
Alright. Someone's got a debit card that if it's not claimed will come straight to me. Joshua Jackson. Oh, there's Joshua Jackson. Do you have an ID to prove it?
Yeah, check that guy's ID.
Yeah, we're gonna have to double check that one right there.
Yeah, I have to double check that one.
Thank you.
it's actually, so when I wrote this, like the lyrics and stuff, I was trying to make it purposefully wordy, so like, if you knew all the words, you'd have to be a diehard, because you're like, yeah, I worked this hard to learn all these words. I have to like this band. I can't stop liking them. I know the words. So that worked. A lot of people are singing a lot of the words. It's impressive. There's a little booklet that that's like the earth. It's kind of like what we made when we went on the tour for this album in 2014. It's like a tiny little book with all the little words in it. So if you don't know them and you need to study up. Sure, let's go. Hotelier song. It's awesome. Okay? Good. It's so neat, right? You already know. Sometimes you see a band and you're like, when are they gonna stop playing? I don't know whether to miss them yet for it. But you know, this is our last song. Or you don't, and that's fine too. Maybe you have the secret bonus deluxe edition that has some extra songs on it. It doesn't exist. Who's ready?
You cut your ties, felt better off. Salutations to your son. We'll be right back.
Gotta adjust these mics. This is the Foxtel-ing.
Foxtelier.
No, so, I don't know. We just wanted to, you know, we're test the guitar. Okay. You know, 10 years ago, did we play Nashville 10 years ago?
Probably.
Who saw us in Nashville 10 years ago?
It was the last show of tour.
At the end of the tour. That makes a lot of sense.
Oh, and we played Magic the Gathering outside. I remember this very fondly, actually.
Me and you?
Everybody.
Oh, everybody?
Yeah.
Ben really loves Magic the Gathering.
No.
Does anybody have any questions about what it's like to be 10 years old? It does get better. PSA. Being 10 is better than being 0. Because when you're, you don't have much control over your anus when you're 0 years old. When you're 10, you can hold it in. This is not gross, this is just common child psychology stuff.
I just want to say, this is, thank you for asking me to do this with you. Because on top of us doing this whole thing together, Christian has just an amazing idea to share a song together at the end of the night, and gave me this song, and I don't know. How many people do you think will know what this is? Zero?
Three.
All right. I think this is one of the most beautiful songs I've ever heard, and I have listened to it so many times to learn it, and I love it so much, and I think it... I'm just very excited to sing it.
Yeah. I think it would just be fun to do a duet. And there's a little also thing about this, which is this is just an old Scottish ballad. It's weird. But like when Hotelier stopped playing shows, I like stopped listening to music altogether. And this is like one of the songs that I was like, oh, actually, like I do love music and I love playing music and I've made so many good friends playing music. Going on tour and seeing faces that I've seen before and that have like helped us out in our lives. It's like kind of like, you know, seeing your family kind of. And so like, I don't know, I just wanted to share a moment with Connor.
Yeah.
And this is us doing that.
Just real quick, one last thing. I talked to Christian in 2021 for a couple hours and we were talking about the classic, how's your pandemic gone and all that kind of stuff is, you know, the thing that every one of us has had a conversation about. And during it, I was like, yeah, what have you been listening to? Have you been writing music? And Christian said, I've just been listening to Irish folk music this entire time since we stopped playing. And I said, well, you should just make an Irish folk record. Make fucking anything, because everybody is very thirsty to hear Hotelier music and hear music from Christian. So. This is the closest thing to that I've heard. So.
Not necessarily.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Anyway.
As I walked out of London Bridge on a misty morning. I overheard that pretty maid crying for the love of a Geordie. Saddle me a milk white steed, bridle me a pony, and I'll ride down to London town and I'll beg for the love of a Geordie. And when she came to the courthouse steps, the poor folks numbered many. 100 crowns she passed around, saying, pray for the love of the Geordie. He never stole a mule or a man. He never murdered any. If he shot one of the king's wild deer, it was only to feed his family. And then she strolled through the marble halls before the judge and the jury. Down on a bended knee she falls, crying for the life of the Geordie. He never stole, he never stole, he never murdered. six free babes I had by the 7-1 lies in my body. And I would bear them all over again. And Geordie will hang from a silver chain, such as we don't hang many. And he'll be laid in your coffin.
Thank you.
don't need to say.
Thanks for the Goo Goo Dolls.